Good evening friends, I am Pradeep Kumar here. I am going to tell you about the installation of Network Simulator 3 in Ubuntu operating system 16.04. So this video I am recording in March 2018. So if you will be waiting for another month, you will be getting Ubuntu 18.04, which is the long term support. So anyhow, I am just installing this Ubuntu 16.04. So I have two windows side by side, one window being the text editor where I will be typing the information when I record. The other window will be, I am just doing the exact operations that perform for installing this Network Simulator 3. So what I do is, so the very first command is, I will be writing sudo apt update. So assuming that I have installed Ubuntu for the first time, I will be issuing this command. So always what you do is, just use this command sudo apt update. So since I am using Ubuntu 16.04, so Ubuntu 16.04 has a facility that you need not give sudo apt get update. So this also it's correct to use, but you need not provide apt get. You can simply use apt update. So the very first command is apt update. So if it is anything, any suggestion is there for upgrading your operating system, it will suggest you. But in my voice, it's given that all packages are up to date. Then next command is, if at all if you have to upgrade something, so you can directly give sudo apt upgrade. So this also been upgraded. Since I have used this OS, this also been upgraded. So I need not upgrade it again. So this is the second command. So you can refer my website www.nsnam.com, nsnam.com, for copying and pasting these instructions. I will be posting these instructions in my website there. So next command is such a very big command. So this is actually NS3 needs so many libraries. So NS3 needs developmental libraries. NS3 needs so many developmental libraries which needs to be installed, which needs to be installed on NS3. So there is a huge list of package list available for installing before you install NS3. So even after if you want to install NS3 directly without installing these packages, you might be getting some errors or warnings from the Network Simulator 3 software. So it is always better to install those packages before if you install NS3. So here is the command. I'm just clicking it here, paste. So I already pasted this here. So if you see, there's a huge list of software. So let me tell you what are the things. It's build essential. So it is nothing but building the entire libraries, like developmental libraries like TCL, TK, Perl, C++, all these things. Then auto configuration, then automake, then X11 libraries for GUI. So then Python libraries, so Python graphical views, and concurrent versioning system. Mercurial is a kind of a build system for NS3, and bzdr, then GitHub, you know, then cmake, P70 bits for compression, decompression, and there are so many Python libraries, and Qt4 is for GUI. So you need to install all these things before you want to go inside the installation of NS3. So what I do is, I just copy it again and then I paste it here in the tab. So this will be installing around 223 MB of archives. So I'm just pressing it yes, so that it will install all the packages. So let me not run the video for the complete installation. Once the installation is over, I will come back to this video. Yes, thank you, and it got installed. You can see this, there are so many packages of 223 MB have been installed here. One warning you may be getting in between, that is by Wireshark. So Wireshark usually have a permission to run the Wireshark only on a normal user mode. So it won't be allowed to run on a GUI in a root user or a super user mode. It will ask whether you want to run it, then Wireshark on a normal user mode, you can make it as yes. Rather than no, you can make it as select as yes. So only that, there's only alert box it will be giving you. So other than that, it doesn't ask you anything, and you'll be getting a terminal like this. So now I will just go to the installation of NS3. So anyway, just check it here. So I am in my home now. So to check what is my home, I use the command echo $home. That is to check what is a home. So I am in home number /home/ Pradeep Kumar. So this is my home here. So what do I do is, I'll just go inside my home. The command for doing this is echo $home. So I just check in my home whether the NS3 software is there. So I have already downloaded NS all-in-one 3.27 tatar.bz2. So this software I already downloaded from the website nsnam.org. So there I have downloaded it. So what you can do is you can instead we have to install this software now. So again now, so the command is, so there are two methods available. So open this software in GUI and I click over it and extract. So that is one method. Other method is using through terminal, because the installation needs through terminal. You cannot install it through GUI, so you have to install it through the terminal. So if you want to use the terminal, let me go with the terminal command here. So since I deal with the command, so I just give this command here. So I will just do it first here. So tar jxvf, this is the J for extracting from bz2, X for extract, V for verbose mode. When the software has been unzipped, you will be getting what kind of file is being unzipped, and F is for force. So copy this and paste it here. So tar jxvf and this. So once it is done, it says this permission is denied because I have copied from my root user. So let me change the file permission and then come back. Yes, I am back now. So what do I do is I'll just use this command tar jxvf. So you can see that the software has been extracted. So the software has been extracted, so the extraction will take only less number of time. So after it has been extracted, we have to install it, or we have to call this build it. So we will be building the entire NS3 libraries. Okay, so once it is done, so if you get any errors like we got previously, so you have to solve those errors. So if you don't get any errors or any warnings as it shows here in the screen, so you need not worry, we will go to the next step. So now when I check it, ls, so we have seen that a folder has been created with the name ns-alignment-3.27. So by the time of recording this video, there is another version of NS3 available, that is NS3.28. So whenever you prefer for a newer version, if you are working on a newer softwares or a newer set of libraries, then you can prefer the latest version. So for example, Wi-Fi, Internet of Things, then wireless personal area networks. So these networks, every day there is a change in their specifications and architecture. So the recent versions also bring in all the changes. So if you want to prefer the latest state of our technologies or the latest updates in the architecture and the protocol applications, so you can use the latest version. So anyway, 3.27 is also being the latest. I am just using this here. So let me go inside the folder ns-alignment-3.27. So after that, I checked it here. So you can see that there is a file in green color, that build.py. So I am going to build using this file only. So please remember, NS3 uses two languages, C++ and Python. So if you are aware of NS2 uses two languages, TCL and C++. So where the front end will be taken care by the TCL and the back end will be algorithms running in the back end as C++. So you need both languages for doing a full-fledged research. But here in NS3, either you need Python or you need C++. You might not need both of the languages at a given instant of time. So if you know only Python, you can play around only with Python without bothering about C++. If you know C++, you can play around only with C++, need not bother about the Python. So that's an added advantage that NS3 have. So now I am going to build this. So directly you can use .less build.py. So .less indicates it is within the current directory. .less is a simple command that indicates that it is a current directory. So within the current directory, I have a executable file called as build.py. And if you want to enable all the examples, --enable-examples, then enable. If you want to enable all the tests that NS3 provides, then you can use it. So please see this --build.py, enable examples and enable test. So Python syntax indicates that, so you need to have before enable, you can see there's a --, and after enable there's a --. So this is how the Python installer variable will show it off. So let me paste it here, so you can use this. And once it is done, it starts compiling the complete, it start building the complete NS3 modules. But here the time taken will be more time it will take, because I am just running this Ubuntu is on a virtual machine I am running. So that has just 1 GB RAM, but my hard disk is on a solid state drive, SSD. So it should be equivalently fast, but when the software is being installed, it takes much time. I already tried it. It takes much time because running on a VM. So even for a conventional machine, if you are installing for the first time, this NS3 will take at least 15 to 25 minutes it takes for the complete installation of NS3. So we have to be patient enough. So what I do is I'll be showing you how many packages it will be installing. So shortly you will get the number on the screen that these many packages will be installed. So it takes some time. So till the time I won't be running this video or I won't be running this record, I'll be switching off this record. So after the complete installation, I'll come back with the recording option. So let me show you how many number of packages that NS3 uses. So NS3 builds so many packages which will be built using the above command. So I'm telling you, since I'm running the virtual machine, so if you are preferring virtual machine over the conventional machine, you will be struggling a lot when you want to build your NS3 for the first time or subsequent time when you want to redo the process. So I always advise you to go for a full-fledged OS if your work is on a research. So don't think that you will be losing your Windows. So you can install in Linux parallelly along with the Windows and then you can do. So here comes. So we can see that there are totally 2704 packages will be installed. And this packages will be built one by one. So it takes, as I said earlier, it takes around 20 to 30 minutes to a max on a VM. So let me come back afterwards. Thank you. Hi. So NS3 is installed successfully here. So you can able to see this here, the list of modules builds, the antenna, the bridge, the core, the DSDV, AODV. So whatsoever the modules are built, everything will be shown here in NS3. So this indicates that the complete build of all the packages in NS3 have been successfully done. And there are some modules which are not been built, for example, bright, click and open flow. So if you are planning to work your research on software defined networking and then network function virtualization, then you can prefer to go for open flow as one of the third party tool that you can configure it for NS3. There's a separate instruction available. You can refer my website www.nsnam.com. And Click is one of a software modular router that also can be built separately. And Bright is from a university that they have developed a package for NS3. So now this is done. Now to check whether my applications are working or not, so I have some applications. So what we do is we just go to NS3.27. So this is the folder structure. You can see this here. So I have installed in home Pradeep Kumar is my home folder. In this I have unzipped this folder all in one 3.27. Inside that I have NS3.27 is a directory. So inside that only I have all this source, everything available. So this is a folder where we have a SRC, means it is a source folder where all the source algorithms, protocols, everything will be available inside the source folder. And there is a examples available here. So in the example, there are some basic tutorials available. You can try this. And there's a folder called as Scratch. So whatever application you develop in NS3, if you want to run it, or see the output of it or get the performance of it, you have to move that corresponding file to Scratch folder. Only then it will be simulated, because the Scratch folder have a special permission in NS3 that whatever you put inside this can be executed. So for example, I do an application. So WAF. So this is the WAF is one of the built method available for running all the applications. Since though it is having a .cc file, we do not have any a.out or anything. So NS3 uses a different application framework called as WAF framework. So ./WAF --run scratch. So maybe I can use without this hello world. Say hello simulator, I think. Let me check it. Yes, so hello simulator. So now this is a simple file that says that when I want to run this example --run hello simulator is one of the name of the application, that to check whether it is working or not. So it the build finished successfully, so it shows that it is hello simulator. So that means the application of NS3 is installed successfully, and there's an application also been executed, an example also been executed. For example, there's a folder called as examples. Under examples we have a file called as tutorial. in the folder called as tutorial. So in the folder we have some examples. You can see first.cc, second.cc, seventh.cc, third. There are up to 7 examples, and there are some examples on Python also. First.py, third.py, second.py. So we have some Python files available. So what I do is I move this file first.cc and first.py into the scratch folder. So what do I do is I'll just move this cp first.star. I'll put both the Python and the C file, previous folder scratch. So I move both the files to scratch folder. So in the scratch folder, so when I want to run it, I just have to come to this NS3.27 folder. Now you might be knowing that why I am using this NS3.27 folder frequently. This is the place that we can able to run our examples. Now for example, to run C++ file and a Python file, we have different syntax. So for I am running a C++ file now, so we will write it here. To run a .cc file, here is the command. The command is /waf --run scratch /ratch the name of the file. So you need not specify the extension. No need to specify the extension. So this is what the command. So now I will write it here, run scratch first. So when I run this, so it will be compiling, because this file is running for the first time, it will compile the corresponding files available in NS3 repository. So after it is done, now we can see this here at time 2 seconds client send this many bytes to port number, and at time this many received from this port and the client. So it is two nodes, node 0 and node 1, they are exchanging some information between them. It's a peer-to-peer network. So an application is being shown here, and this is what the output of the typical network application. So this is for running C++ file. So now the same thing, to run a Python file, the command is slightly different, /waf --pyrun. So pyrun is for Python run, scratch /first.py. So here we have to specify the extension. So we need to specify the extension. So let me run it here, the same example, because they have given how C++ and Python differs. The same example you can see in /waf --pyrun scratch first.py. Yes, now the same example, now it is running in Python. Okay, so this is the difference. But for example, if I try something wrong here, waf --run scratch first.cc. When I type first.cc here, rather than without, I need not specify any extension here, but I am specifying it. So you will be shown an error like this. So you see that it shows a massive error which you cannot recollect it. So assume if you get an error like this in red color, you understand that you provided something wrong in the command. So try to change the command. Similarly, first in now for .py, I am not giving .py. Here is Python pyrun, but only first. In this case also, it is saying error that user bin Python cannot open file scratch first, because it needs a file with the name .py. So if it doesn't provide, then it will give a code like this. So please remember, for C++ you need not provide any extension, but for Python you should provide extension. The running command is pyrun, and here there it is run. So that's all about the basic installation of NS3. So NS3 installation is over. So please refer my websites nsnam.com for more details. Also subscribe to my channel. youtube.com/tspradeepkumar. So this is my channel, you can subscribe for it. So you have any queries, you can always ping me either through my blog or through my website. So thank for giving your time. Thank you very much.